हेलो
हाँ हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग सर, वेलकम। हाँ
मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग। माय वॉइस इज क्लियर सर?
सर, यस सर, क्लियरली ऑडिबल।
यस सर, थैंक यू। यस
पीपीटी स्क्रीन, शेयर द स्क्रीन।
सर। Is it right now live?
यस यस सर, जस्ट इट इज शोइंग। यस,
यस।
नमस्ते सर,
नमस्ते सर, हाउ आर
ग्रीटिंग्स
यू
एंड
सर?
वेलकम टू आत्रेय आयुर्वेद एकेडमी।
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर। आफ्टर लॉन्ग टाइम आई एम
गणेशना
सीन।
2020, वेलकम टू।
यस सर, यस सर।
शाल आई मूव सर, शाल आई
Yes,
प्रोसीड?
sir. Please, sir. If it is everything is right, go ahead. No problem.
यस सर, आवर टीम विल इंट्रोड्यूस यू फर्स्ट।
No problem,
यस सर,
sir.
हेलो।
Shall I start, sir?
या, यू कैन स्टार्ट इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द गेस्ट स्पीकर फर्स्ट एंड देन वेलकम ऑल अदर्स पार्टिसिपेंट्स।
Shall I start, sir?
यस,
प्लीज
प्लीज।
गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वरा गुरु साक्षात परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी, सेकेंड ईयर पंचकर्मा पीजी स्कॉलर, तानाथ गवर्नमेंट आयुर्वेदिक मेडिकल कॉलेज, बल्लारी। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक आत्रेय आयुर्वेद अकेडमी, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू गवेशन ऑफ फिफ्थ वेबिनार सीरीज बाय डॉक्टर अजित लिंगायत ऑन एनालिटिकल रिसर्च इन आयुर्वेदा, इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स यूजफुल इन रिसर्च। आई वेलकम अवर ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर वसंत सी पाटिल सर एंड एडवाइजर डॉक्टर दुर्गाबाई केंद्र भट्ट सर। Thank you. Now I would welcome to Dr. Pinky CM for introduction of today's guest lecture. Thank you, sir.
Good morning, everyone. Once again, I welcome you all to the fifth section of webinar series, Analytical Research in Ayurveda, by Dr. Ajit Lingayat sir. Sir has completed graduation from Ayurveda and MSc in Medicinal Plants from Gujarat Ayurveda University in Jamnagar, and sir has completed their PhD from KLE University. So currently, sir is working as Associate Professor, Department of Dravyaguna at Kahals Sri B.M. Panganavadi Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya, Belgaum, and production supervisor at KLE Ayurveda Pharmacy. Sir is the technical expert of AYUSH approved ASU drug testing at KLE Ayurveda. Sir has professional teaching experience of more than 13 years and research experience of more than 11 years. Sir has published 11 articles and attended more than 28 workshops. Thank you, sir. Over to you, sir. You start the section, sir.
Thank you very much. I think I am audible to all. I'm audible to all and
yes sir, audible.
Okay, thank you.
Yes sir.
Thank you for Atre Academy to invite me as a resource person and your kind words regarding my introduction. I'm really thankful to all team for giving me opportunity to give a lecture. Okay, this is a topic we are going to be seeing, the analytical research in Ayurveda, instruments useful in research. This is the topic I'm going to be share. Likely to given, I am giving you share my experience along with these instruments because I am working since 12 years in this Ayurvedic field. Basically, I am a B Pharma Ayurved. Therefore, I am working with pharmacy also and teaching also. That is one of the good opportunity I got chance to teach the Ayurvedic physicians in UG and PG level. I'll try to understand their issues regarding the drug and what is the issues regarding the research. That is one of the good
Excuse me, sir. Ajit, sir, please unmute yourself, sir.
Is there? Okay. Audible right now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sorry. Okay. This is the analytical research, and we are going to be seeing. This is the what is the requirement? Why we want to do the analytical research into Ayurveda? That is very important thing. You should having requirement of 90% of why. Why should be clear. What instrument to be taken? Why should be taken? How it is going to be used, it is a very 10% work that we can do it, and we can develop skill regarding that. That is not a big task, but why it is need, because using a particular instrument and obtaining one data and interpreting the data from that particular instrument, how it is going to be helpful and how we create the standards or evidence regarding that. Okay, this is the good thing, and I'm really lucky to have teaching experience with the Ayurvedic physicians. That is, therefore, I can give much better idea regarding this. Okay. This is our actually it is created by our principal. That is a traditional technology innovation by our principal, sir. And really, I appreciate inspired from this particular thing, because from Lord Dhanvantri to till date. And their passing knowledge is going on. They are documented and they are going to be explored day by day. We are already traditional system or traditional things are there. We are having our classics. We are imparting day by day or using the new technology to particular thing to evolve it. And after that, we are going to bring a new innovation. Why required a new innovation? Because as we are likely to be in present condition, we are having COVID-19. Okay, there is a COVID-19 infection and the virus is there, and right now the world is don't have any medicines or particular anything for to prevent, or it is not going to be curable. Like that, this is the condition is there, and there are everybody is looking towards the Ayurveda and herbal drugs to give something new thing, or they can save the lives of human beings. Okay, everything, if your Ayurveda is there or your Ayush system is there, any system is there. Two, it is used only for your to save the lives of the human beings. That is the basic concept behind this, and you can make a good lives of the human beings. For that purpose, we are going to be these things are going to be come across. Some will give some introduction regarding that what actually it is, how we are going to be deep into particular topic. The Ayurvedic medicines is one of the world's oldest medical system. Everybody is known. It is a before century. It is coming from Lord Dhanvantri is passing through till date, and it is one of the India's traditional healthcare system. It is also spreading towards the world right now. Every world is accepting our system, and the Ayurvedic medicines right now. The every physician is required medicines. Okay, at Allopatha is there or Ayush is there. Every physician is required medicines. Everybody's is diagnoses are good. No issues regarding this. But there is a major play role to meet that particular diagnosis, to treat the symptoms or disease. The medicine is the main role is there. For particular that, we are using Ayurvedic medicines right now in India for internal external use, for diagnosis, treatment, mitigation and prevention of disease and disorders. Okay, and this is for humans and animals. Right now, the Ayurvedic products are also coming for your animal purpose also. It is coming. Right now, the Ayurveda is also coming into big era of nutraceuticals. Ayurveda coming with the cosmeceuticals. Okay, these are the, some fragmentation or categories of the medicines. They are coming to the human beings to utilize them to particular their welfare. That is going to be what. Then right now, analytical research, because it is a matter of medicines. Therefore, medicine is very, very much important, because it is going to be directly hit your health. Therefore, we should know, because we are planning, we are designing, and we are having medicines to well-being of the human beings. Therefore, right now we are taking any allopathic medicines, we are having exact effect, exact side effect, everything is known for us. Where in Ayurveda, because of the drug is having some maturity level, the production systems and everything, where we are having good effect, but we should not calculate the side effects also. Okay, and it is going to be unpredictable sometimes. That is maybe there, but Ayurvedic medicines are much safer than other medicines, and we are going to utilize n number of disease and disorders right now. The analytical research that will give, that is the particular thing, the processing and computing of the information, composition of structure matter, because when we are combining the drugs, that is going to be make one structure. What is that structure? What is the composition of that structure? Determine what matter it is and how much it is exist. Okay, means what matter it is actually, when after we are giving samskara, when we are compounding the drug, as Ayurvedic medicines, they are prepared by panchavit kashaya kalpana. Okay, basically just clear for you, because we are using panchavit kashaya kalpana, we are having base of water extract, it is much more clear. Right now government is approved to Ayurveda for hydroalcoholic or alcoholic or other solvents also, because to give better results with the herbs. And that will pharmaceutical analysis used, because we require the purity, how much pure drug is there, safety and quality of the drug. Because the purity, safety and quality. Safety is required because it should not be untoward side effect, anything else. And quality of the drug give the consistent result, what doctor is expected. And again, what results we are expecting from that particular medicines should be desired that effect. Therefore, quality is maintained. The purity, because sterility is there, hygiene, it is very important to maintain that particular thing. We should see the analytical data we are generating. Again, what analytical research or instruments is giving to us? They're giving qualitative and quantitative chemical analysis to ensure the raw material and finished product with desired specifications. Okay. As right now, the Ayurvedic medicines, all Ayurvedic medicines are having the standards with the Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia of India. First, we have to refer this book for standard, the a single drug or any compound drug, and their standards, if it is mentioned in Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia India, we have to refer that book, because it is the official book published by our government to standardize or give the quality of the our drug, how much quality should be drug is there, one. Second, we have to go with the another book by the CCRS, which is already right now out of print, Pharmacopoeia standards for Ayurvedic formulations. That is PSF, short form, it is called like PSF. It is right now out of print, but still that book is very good. They are having some another, lots of medicines they are standardized and their quality control standards are given. After that, we can refer Indian pharmacopoeia. Okay, because we are using some synthetic preservatives, sodium benzoate or methylparaben, propylparaben, like that we are using. For particular that synthetic, or we are using some beeswax, lots of things we are using from that particular part, that we can refer Indian pharmacopoeia. Therefore, whatever analytical data is given, that will be given the specification, then you can say that our drug is standard. Okay, if your product is not meet the particular specification, then your product is rejected. And unnecessarily, we are not claiming that our drug is safe or something, it is another issue. Second, in the part of export, because right now the heavy metals and your pesticidal residue, these are the two major issues are coming out of the Ayurvedic medicines. They are likely to be highlighted by the foreign countries or abroad peoples, but they are wrong, but because they don't understand the particular manufacturing procedures. But still, what specification they want, okay, what specification they are going to be used, that specification also we can comply. Then our medicine acceptability is very well throughout the world. That is important thing. Right now you can see the yoga is gone out of the India, and that will be spread right now throughout the world, and they are accepted and people are learning like everything, and they are practicing because of it is having one kind of their acceptance. They got the standards like that. When they want to practice abroad or out of India, then we should give some particular specifications. And either we can generate data that this particular matter with particular quantity, if it is having, it is also safe. We have to show it at clinical, animal, lots of standard levels are there, we have to show. Right now we are going to be restricted ourselves to right now for analytical research, we are going to be seeing right now. What is the major objective of all those things, tasks we are going to be seen in the instrumentation in analytical research? And apart from that, I will add after that one, that is, we have to see the drug is free from impurities, because we are using drug as a whole. Second, we are using drug in a natural form. Therefore, impurities are by default, they are coming into the medicines. But it should be in a limit first. Otherwise, it should be free from impurities. We have to cultivate the drug. We can make harvesting of our drug like this, or collection of ores from the particular mines. We have to take care. Like that, we should drug free from impurities. After that data, we can say our drug is not having heavy metals. We can say our drug is don't have any pesticidal residue in that, because pesticides, they are going to be sprayed on the particular herbal drugs, especially. They are having absorb into the plant parts, and they are retained in particular things. That is very dangerous, but it should be, we can say it is a free form impurities. Then second thing is physical and chemical stability of the drug. Drug means it is a raw and finished, both things are there. Okay, physical and chemical stability means when your drug is there, it should not affected by the microbial growth major, because in herbals it is one of the biggest task. We are going to be preserving drug, because when drug is collected in natural form, from that end to end user, till having supplier, then the pharmacies, then doctor, and then it will come to the patient. In that particular chain, the drug should be in a hygiene form, and it should be stable, all constant, because we are using drug as a whole. Therefore, we should not leave a single minute phytochemical from our drug, because every minute and minute phytochemical is having their role into drug action in IFL. Because we are not telling that particular vidanolite, we are not telling that particular ricinin or particular thing is working. They are working. But apart from that, all phytochemicals, all polyphytochemicals, because our drug is called as polyphytochemical, not a particular phytochemical, it's a polyphytochemical or chemical, herbo mineral, some mineral also is coming in there. Then all are required into the particular drug action. That is very important. Therefore, it should be stable in throughout process till end use. That is very important. And the contents, what we are contained, we are labeled in this label, in the particular product label, what contents we are given, that this active ingredient is having this much quantity. It should be retained till use and till its shelf life. Before that, we are 2010 onwards, we got shelf life for Ayurvedic medicines, and recently we added for Aswarishta also. Previously Aswarishta, no expiry date, but they are given 10 years. Okay, like that, we are having that shelf life, that Churna 2 years, Grita 2 years, Tela 3 years. Like that, your Rasa Aushad is 5 years. Like that, Basma, some Basmas are late and all, they are no expiry. But still, whatever the, throughout your storage, throughout your process, your drug should be stable. Okay. This is very important thing that we are going to be checked by analytical research. Therefore, we are doing our drug analysis as raw material, in process and processed. After that, the drug inspectors or our some authorities are drawing the sample and check the product quality. And the recently, the last year, the government of India is implemented for us stability study. Whenever a new proprietary medicines, if I'm clear, new proprietary medicines you want to brought into the market, it should go to the stability study. It is an accelerated stability study we had to go through at accelerated or natural, whatever it is there. Okay, it is a natural is there, then we had to go for full tenure. If Churna is there, we had to check the stability for 2 years. Accelerated, we can do it in a six months, and we are exponentially, we can going to be say that it is having this much stability. Okay, this is the thing. Next is the detection of substitution and adulteration of the drug. Very important, because Ayurvedic herbs, because herbs are there, and right now the herbs, some of herbs, the 30% herbs they are using in home communities, means day-to-day life, these herbs are going to be used, hinga, then your jeera, lavang, like that. They are also using, and they are going to be substituted. Okay, they are going to be substituted with the exhausted variety or low grade variety. That is the issue. Because here the challenge is in Ayurvedic medicine, because her rate is going to be increasing day by day. Okay, it is not stable or allopathic medicines. The medicine rate is going to be somewhere, it is going to be declined. once he's got the synthesis procedure, they can synthesize easily, and it is going to be somewhere, it is going to be decline. But there is no issue in Ayurvedic drugs. It is going to be day by day it is increasing, because the raw material resource, it is very limited with us. Therefore, we have to take care of these things. Therefore, substitution we have to detect it. Adulteration. Adulteration is there, as I told him, with yellow chalk powder, but adulteration with our some drugs which is not used in the home community. For example, Patla, Shona, Bala. Okay, these are the some drugs they are having in the wild, but they are not having a good amount of plants. Therefore, we have to adulterate it. They are going to be adulterated with some another thing. We have to check that quality of that particular drug. Because we are using Dashmularish, we are using Ashokarish, Bala. They are having one of the these three. I have taken a group. There is these three are very widely used in Ayurvedic medicines. Okay, therefore, detection of adulteration is also very important. By this research, we can obtain. Then, optimal release of the active ingredient when it is administered. As the last lecture is there with the pharmacology, the sir is definitely told that absorption, distribution, metabolism, and excretion of the drug, where when we are taking the drug, it should be optimal release, means it should be go to the systematic circulation and it should be reached to the site of action. That is very important thing. And how much it is going to be administered and how it is going to be you reach particular site of action and how much quantity, because once it is going to be, it is going to be coming to the biochemical pathway and your some another cell content and everything, it should be go to the maximum amount of medicines and it give desired effect. Okay, because if it is drug is not reaching to the systematic circulation up to that, then it is no use. We are not getting results. That is directly proportional with the results. Okay, therefore this is also we can get it by analytical research. And last and very important, the ensure the proper GMP. Okay, we are going to be seeing the GMP, because good manufacturing practices for the manufacturing of the product. Right now, the very 18th century, we can calculate, or 19th century mid, the Ayurvedic system of medicine is limited to the vaidyas. Okay, the vaidyas are preparing their medicines, giving to their patients. Right now, the explore and globalization of Ayurveda and acceptance of herbal medicines, the Ayurveda has come out and go to the hands of the industry peoples. Okay, then the industry peoples, they should understand what is GMP. What is the requirement of that particular drug, how drug should be procedure, and it should not be alter the drug chemicals. That is very important thing, and that will give the results of the desired effect. Okay, this is very important thing. Therefore, proper application of GMPs, because when you people are dealing with the patients right now, the patient will be come to you, sir, you given up one medicine, it is not useful and it is unaffected. Everything is hampering to the Ayurvedic system. Okay, therefore, whenever you are also seeing the particular thing, when you are coming, any tablet you are taken, you are taking his smell, you are taking his fineness, and then you are going to decide how it is going to be worked. Okay, therefore, proper application of GMP is there or not, we can ensure by this particular analytical research. Okay, then this is the background. Again, I want to add one thing, that why it is come to these things are there, because the right now the you people are there into the BMS with MD Ayurveda, they are going to be research officers, drug inspectors. When they are coming into the policy making, this is the challenges which is right now untold to anybody. The government is still focusing on that, and they are not getting proper idea to how to implement particular thing, because we are having three issues: improper collection, improper storage, and improper your cultivation. Okay, and lastly, improper manufacturing. These are the three, four major issues we are having. The proper manufacturing is there, but the industry is required much more feedback from your side to how make it in a cost effective way and good way. Therefore, this is very important. We can't leave it, because this also topic is not covered that much in deep in your BMS studies. As I think everybody is in PG scholars right now. But you are in PGs, when you are doing PG studies, this much is not that much you are, because you are come with some macro and micro in Dravyamana, then manufacturing in the Rashastra. Means this you are doing some short of introductory pharmaceutical work in your BMS studies. Therefore, it is very important. Okay, this is going to be. Then selection criteria, how we are selecting the instrument. Okay, that is very important thing. Okay, the accuracy. How much accuracy you want? For example, if you want moisture content, then there is a range, not more than 5%. Means you can go with oven or water bath. Okay. Then if you want particular in oil, I want not more than 0.5. Then you have to change the main instrument. You have to go with particular instrument, IC filtration, moisture analyzer, where we can get it. Then precision. Precision means that instrument should not be affected by the particular environment. Again, accuracy of the particular results is given by the precision. Okay. Then sensitivity. Sensitivity means it is going to be sensitive to moisture, if sensitive to your environmental conditions. Okay, a particular drug is there. If that sensitivity is there, and for example UV is there, it is required for closed chamber. Okay, that sensitivity is required, then we have to maintain that particular things and check that one and use it. Specificity and selectivity. Okay, specificity. When you want fingerprinting, we have to go with HPTLs. If you want to take only the what are the phytochemicals are there, then you can go with simple TLC. So no issue for this particular thing. Robustness and ruggedness. Okay, that is you are having. It should not be affected by any particular environmental conditions. Okay, means if something minute variation is happened, it should not be variation in particular thing. Then scale of operation. Okay, you want to small scale, large scale. Like that, if you want, then you have to go with that particular scale of operation. We have to think it. Then equipment, time and cost. Okay, equipment is there. You have to see the equipment. Is it available with us, or is it is going to be used, or that much required for that, and how much time is taken for particular analytical the data that we have to take it. Then as I told that if you go for TLC, you are getting only the fingerprinting, or we are going to be separation of phytochemical, but you will not get quantitative data or isolation of particular phytochemical from particular thing. Therefore, we have to go for HPTLs. Okay, like that, we have to see the equipment, the cost also. Okay, because the right now the manufacturing cost of medicine is too much high. If you add analytical cost in that particular analysis of the drug, it is important. It's not not disagreeing, but it is.
Ajit Linga, sir.
Please, sir. Sir,
hello.
Sir, hello. 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 Sir. Hello. Hello, sir. Hello. Hello.
Ajit, sir, you are audible, sir.
Oh, can I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Okay, there is the sir is asked me, therefore I call it stop. Okay.
No, sir, it's audible, sir.
Okay. This is another thing we want to clear it, that how much speed is required, and easy and convenience is how much is there, and skill operation is required. Then cost and availability of the equipment per sample cost, and the what is the after this we have to make the final choice of the particular instrument. Okay, this is the right now Ayurvedic drug research and innovation is going on right now. Any drug will become that will be pharmacognostical, macro and micro, then physical, chemical, biological, and then it is goes to chemical evaluation. Oh, sorry, clinical evaluation. When it is going to be stable, or we are getting the animal studies good, and then we go for going to be seen the what is the clinical activity, what is the final activity right now is there. Okay, right now we are going with restricted ourselves with the pharmacognostical, then physical and chemical, and some part of microbial. Okay, I am not going for animal studies. These four I am going to be cover. Some instruments are there which is widely used or specifically used or continuously used in the Ayurvedic drug research. These are the category of the our Ayurvedic drugs. Was we are using raw materials from plant, animal, and mineral source, and our dosage forms are arka, swarishta, churna. It is like this. We are having apart from that, right now Ayurveda has explored to gel, serum, and the suspension emulsion like that is come across with this particular thing. First, very important thing, we'll go with the raw material. There will be simple dissecting microscope we are using for particular to see the morphological and topography of the samples. Okay, the inspection of the fractures. Fracture is the one of the important character to see what is the fracture action on the particular rod. Okay, when you are cut sound, when you are going to see, for example, kutki, when it is going to be cut, we are getting cut sound. Okay, pipli, if you break it, you get the cut sound. Then you can say it is a moisture free. Then it is a good pipli is there. And you can say it is a mature also. If it is immature is there, will not get cut easily or will not give some sound. Then dissect the raw materials, because we have to dissect the raw material and we check the what are the inside, because importantly it is going to be with the flowers. When it is flowers, we are using that kamal pushpa, then your japa and everything. They are having lots of variety inside. We have to dissect the particular raw material and check the what is the species is there, whatever we are expecting raw material or specific drug is there or not. And it is also used right now the foreign matter, one of the standard is there for raw material, we have to use it. Okay, this is the thing, and this is some advancement in dissecting microscope is there, what we shown into your picture. I give an example, that earth mould, that is Calotropis procera, where the API is telling that it is a rough, fissured, longitudinally corky, soft, externally yellowish gray, while internally it is white and central fold is cream color. Okay, they are given, it is a morphological observation of the drug. Okay, that is very important thing. And then you can see it here, I keep the photographs where we are going to clearly see it is a rough structure, somewhat fissured and longitudinally corky and soft surface is there, yellowish gray color, like that we are going to be saying. Then we have to go with the odor and your taste is there with the organoleptic method. It is also coming to, you can do it and you can say, because this is very important thing. And because by smell only we can say it is a prickly or it is having kapoor or something, jeera. If smell is very less, we are also telling that we can judge this particular thing, if this drug is having low quality or something is going to be have some problem with that drug. Next, we are going to be, once it is drug is morphologically identified, we are go for compound microscopy, or that is microscopic study. Why it is we are going to go for microscopic study? Because by some right now I told that earth mould we seen, but we can't say there is a two species of earth, Calotropis procera and Calotropis gigantea. Right now I have taken a section of Sahachara. Okay, right now I have given a section of Sahachara, and this is very important because Sahachara is having around 4 to 5 varieties, different colors of flowers. Okay, then what particular color flower or particular root is we required? By particular identifying particular species, we have to check that particular thing. Therefore, we are doing microscopy of the drug. Okay, then powder microscopy we are going to be seeing, because when drug is coming to the powder microscopy, then we have to check what is the condition of the powder microscopy. Okay, then here I have given the powder microscopy of Quercus infectoris, that is Miaphyll. Then it is a stone cell and starch grain and elongated sclerites are there. These are the there, and this is the compound microscope. Generally, it is attached with your softwares where we can identify the structure. We can check the structure and their particular quantification of the structure. We can do it. Okay. Advancement of in microscopy, we are having fluorescent microscope. Okay. Right now, this fluorescent microscope is used for scattering and reflecting adhesion or absorption of the study, the properties of organic and inorganic substances. Means lots of particular apparatus or equipments are available with right now with the physics, chemistry, biology, biochemistry and biotechnology lab. But how we can implement in our research, that is in our hand. Right now fluorescent microscope is already used. Right now we are using this fluorescent microscope. Can we do it with some dyes or particular chemical, microchemical structure, where we can say that this particular bala is there, Siddha particle. If you stain it particular with the stain, and we can say it, this is a bala, or we can say it, this is having some adulteration with another drug. Like that is fluorescent microscope, because we are having fluorescent light here, UV light, where we can, right now we are using, we are also having this microscope, And right now we are using for cancer cell lines, okay, tissue cultures, cancerless cell lines when we are treated with the extract, how the cells, they are looked.
Hello, Ajit sir. We're not unable to hear you, sir.
Audible, it is there again.
Yes, sir. No audible, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. This is microtome, and right now we are using this microtome with for plant section also. But there is an issue with this particular instrument because this instrument is having 50 micron maximum. We can get it thickness one. Again, we will not get the good section with the up to 15 micron. Because plant cells and tissues, when we are going to be click it, they are having different thickness at different level. Therefore, we are going to get to 15 micron and above. That is good that we are going to be seeing. But still, it is a useful instrument to take a section for plant sections of your plant material. Then right now, the apart from microtome, that is the advancement to the cryostat. Okay, this is right now the advanced instrument. It is also used for sectioning. Okay, it is a cryostat, and it is under low temperature with high speed, and we are getting a good fine section of particular drug. Okay, and it is having, this is the advancement in a microtome. The limitations is softness of this. Okay, because they are having the molds. Right now we are looking here, this kind of molds are there. They are keeping in this particular machines. They are having problem with this particular thing is there. They are having thickness is different. Second, they are having don't space to cut that particular thing. Okay, and the gel is there. What is going to be freeze in minus 80 degree, it is there in that particular instrument, and that should hold a particular sample. Okay, that is very other issues with that, but it is one of the instrument we can use it, and we can take a section of particular drug. One, second, we can use it by different part of the particular raw material, and you take a section, then you have to join it, and you can check the section to identify the particular plant. Right now, macro and micro, but right now we are entering the chemical analysis, where the very important and very basic instrument is there, that is analytical balance. Okay, it is highly sensitive, and it is for accurate measurement. It is not something rough measurement. It is very accurate measurement, because when you are going to be implement your analysis on higher end, which is on UV or IR like HPTLC, where we can say that where we are required the accurate weight. If weight is vary, the everything results is going to be vary, and we are getting the different results what we are not expected, or it is going to be interpret a wrong dimensions of your research. And it means having chamber to prevent smaller samples from the being affected from the air. It should not be affected by the air, and it is accuracy we required generally 0.1 to like 0.01 gram, or it is 1 mg that is there. And as per need, okay, what how much sensitivity or how much accuracy we want, we can do it. But here the limitation is there, we should not go beyond 200 gram weight, any analytical balance, because any analytical balance is we are given there the maximum there, but you should not go beyond 200 gram, because at higher level it is not sensitive for anything. Okay, this is very important. Then first test, we have first instrument again we are going to use after analysis is there, hot air balloon. Okay, it is electrical device by drive to heat the sterilize the equipment. Okay, major work is there with this particular thing. It is going to sterilize the equipment, and there's thermostat controlled temperature. They are used for glassware sterilization, and it is going to be specifically it is used for moisture content loss on drying test. this instrument is going to be used. Here maximum degree we can go for 100 and 105. Okay, but for loss of moisture, you can't go for volatile containing drop. You should not go for that, because volatile, they are going to be volatile at 40 degree only. Then your moisture content may be showing more. Therefore, we have to restrict it. This is only without volatile containing drop. Or you can go for some drying of the extract. Okay, that is not containing any thermolabile chemicals. Okay, then next is your muffle furnace. We are going to be seeing that is muffle furnace is there. Everybody is knowing. I think it is or vertical. You already used in your copy paper like that. It is having horizontal one. Okay, it is furnace used for ashing purpose. Very important thing. It is ashing purpose, and it is specifically used for acid value and acid insoluble ash, water soluble, sulfated ash, and flash value of the truck. Okay, but if you are putting 3-4 ash at a time, you will not get the proper ash, because there is a particular indication for a particular instrument by getting ash. It should be whitish ash. It should not containing carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. It is free from C, H, and O. If it is some blackishness is there in your ash, means your ash is not completed. Okay. If you are having any impurities in particular drug, like heavy metals, you are having some pesticides, or they are having some pollutants on that, your ash value is going to be different. Okay. This is therefore it is muffle furnace is there, and when we are doing the ash, it allow it to cool as it is, and here we are using maximum degrees 450 degree. Okay, we are using 450 degree in your ashing purpose. So that is very important thing. We are using for 450 degree at least for 1 hour to 3 hours. We are using okay that for particular ash. It is very important thing. Therefore, we are telling that we are whenever using it should be allowed to cool it properly. Should not be allowed to cool it properly, then ash will not be properly, because once your ash will create, you have to go with acid insoluble ash and water soluble and sulfated ash with that ash only. Every time you can't prepare a new ash. Okay, that is also important. Then very important thing is there, water bath. Again, we are using this is for indirect heating purpose. Here maximum temperature is 105 degrees Celsius. Used for specific test, that is total solids, water soluble extract. Okay, that is going to be. And water and alcohol soluble extractive value, it is going to be used. And here we can go for some moisture content also of some drugs containing volatile or particular your cream or lotions, particular thing we are going to be seeing. Then it is the desiccator. What we are going to be seeing, that is purpose of desiccator is dry or chemical become wet form and atmospheric humidity. Whenever drug will be moisture will be removed, when you are did ash value, you are keeping your samples, you should not use it directly for weighing. That is important thing. Therefore, it should be come to the normal temperature, at room temperature. Then we have to go for keep it into your desiccator. And that is desiccant that absorb moisture from your drug. When you are removing your ash from furnace or water bath, we have to go with keep it in a desiccator. For that, we are using CaSO4, silica gel, MSF, magnesium sulfate, or P2O5. That we are using some chemicals to absorb moisture from the your drug. And it is specifically in the ash value. It is because ash is having very fineness, and it will easily catch the moisture fastly. Therefore, when complete your ash procedure, you have to put your crucible into desiccator. Then Clevenger apparatus, another instrument is there. It is we are going to be used for volatile extraction, and it is going to be used generally solvent is used as a water. Okay. Here, because Clevenger apparatus is not the cheap and workable instrument to check the volatile content from your lavang or any other drug or jirak or lots of things, because when you are using in a bulk quantity, the sample will be come, the proper sampling will be done, and we can say how much percentage of volatile is there, because it is one of the standard into the API for volatile containing drug. For example, Jetamoxin, okay, like that, where we can say and how we can see how much is there, then we can judge it from this particular instrument and we can quantify the volatile factor. Here we can see we have to soak the drug for overnight in that particular rock bottom flask, and this is containing water only and giving heat to boil it up to 40-45 degree, and then we are getting the volatile. And here what we are getting here, the V shape. Okay, here is the collection of your particular volatile here, and that is going to be checked by, after that it is going to be removed from here and we see the quantification, and there is a readings over here in the particular scale, how much volume is there in that. Another important thing, and it is common, we already did it in your some basic level in the 11-12, that is acid base reactions, and this is pH of the sample, that is your pH meter. Okay, it is one of the important instruments. And but when you are going to see the pH paper and pH instrument, they are having here it is specificity and precision is coming out of this, and this is giving much precise result, and we are getting the pH value of particular drug. Therefore, this instrument is showing the acidity and alkalinity of your solution. Okay, this is specifically used in Asavarishta, where we are having acidic range is fixed 3.5 to 5.5 generally. This API is given for almost all Asavarishtas this much, because whenever as we are telling that Asavarishta is as old as old is very good, but the when alcohol is generation is there, again there is a generation of your acid is there along with this. Therefore, this is also we have to check with that particular instrument. Okay, and this is the pH will be calibrated by the generally the buffer solutions of 4, 7, and 9.2. Okay, this is the three generally we are using, or any known buffers we are going to be checked by the we can calibrate this instrument. Next is your pycnometer. This is specific gravity we are going to be seeing, and this is we can get the weight per ml of your sample or specific gravity of your liquid. Okay, whenever we are using powder also it is going to be used specific gravity, because when it is going to be we are making kashaya or we are making any syrup or oil, the specific gravity alter because of the drug interaction and the drug quality also. Because when you are going to be or adulteration in oil also, okay, it is basically for adulteration of oil also we can detect this is going to be changed. Okay, because density and volume is going to be changed, then specific gravity is going to be changed, because it is going to be weighed with the known volume as we are going to be seeing the 10 25 ml 50 100 ml, as per requirement we can go and we are going to be checked, and it is a physical property. Go for room temperature. Then you will see the refractive index, that is Abbe's refractometer, and this is going to be checked. Abbe's refractometer, and this is most refractometer is equal to accuracy to use to check the refractive index of your oil. And right now we are going to be seeing how the advancement is there. So basically scales are there in the eyepiece, but still we are going to be seeing that they are putting the digital meter for check that one. And it is going to be checked. You can use it light source, or you can go for sodium light for light source. And this is very important too, because refractive index is also changed by the adulteration and substitution of the oil. Okay, this is very important thing that we have to check from particular refractive index. And there is very important thing, because when we are doing mrudu, madhyam, and tikshna paka of your oil, if this paka is totally karpa, the refractive index will be checked. Change mrudu is there, that is also changed, and madhyam is that is also changed. Then you can check what is the pack of that particular drug. We can see it by this particular instrument. Then distillation assembly, that is right now we are seeing this distillation assembly for your arca preparation, and we are right now using this particular thing is for your alcohol distillation. Okay, or we can also collect the volatile matter, that like as I told in arca, right, we can go for. Because what will volatile matter will collect, that will go for high end analysis of gas chromatography and HPLC studies. Right now we can distill the alcohol from this and go for specific gravity method, and we can quantify the alcohol percentage, or we can distill the alcohol from this particular instrument apparatus, and we can go for alcohol meter, we can use it for particular alcohol percentage. Next is there substrate extraction. This is continuous extraction, as we are going to be seeing here complete extraction. Therefore, whenever we are using here solvent, but here we are not using water as a solvent, that is very much important. We can go for hydroalcoholic, alcoholic, or any other. Okay, because we should not, because here condenser is having water condensation, because for right now the blue condenser you are getting is containing water to condense the solvent. Okay, and this is you are having sample holding here. Once this is your solvent and it is having heating mantle here, and once it is going to be heat, the solvent will evaporate, come here, condense here, deposit here, then it is going to be fill it and come again back to the solvent, and it is going to be go up to the colorless of your solvent. Whereas alcohol is colorless, you have to go for extraction of the colorless. Okay, then you have to taken out this extract, dry it, and you can calculate the percentage, or you can take that extract for further analysis. Then we are going for Schiff-Seckert. This is for very important thing for particle size distribution. Okay, because the right now the coarse powder and fine powder, these are the two major granules are there. These are two, three forms we are using in the powder form. We are in the products. Therefore, we have to go for test of particle size distribution is very important, because as for example, we want coarse material, it should be 40 to 60 mm. Maximum should be retained on there. Otherwise, if it is passing, you are getting problem in pressure. Okay, this is the interpretation from particular thing that we have to check. Then we come for Brookfield viscometer. Okay, viscosity testing, it is there. Right now, Ostwald viscometer, very laboratory grade is there. I have not put a photograph. It is very simple instrument is there that we are also having. We are also using that one for viscosity. Right now, the viscometer, this is Brookfield viscometer, is going to be used for a particular viscosity purpose, and that is give more precision to viscosity. Okay, that is very important, and totally digitally handle this instrument. Right now we are getting, this is the your spindle is there, that spindle is rotating and your sample is below that particular spindle, and that is giving the resistance to flow. The viscosity measure basic definition is flow, that is resistance, how much that spindle is required to rotate and how much it is going to be resisted, that will be calculated by this instrument. Then hardness tester, that is very important thing in the tablet. The hardness testing is a laboratory technique and in pharmaceutical generally used for tablets. It is containing Google Kalpa, in Ayurveda it is used for all tablets, there are COB and everything. It will come in whatever even tablet form, we can go for this. Here there is a main two types are there, Monsanto, these are the scientists, Pfizer is another scientist, they invented this test instrument to check the hardness of the tablet, because we are using binders. Then we can use it some new drug which is we are going to be having, just for example, we are using any latex containing drug that will give more hardness to particular drug when it is going to be bhavna or particular drug. It is not. For example, right now we are facing problem with Google. The hardness is much more. We have to break it by another way. Then only it is going to break one. To check that particular hardness, we have to check. And right now the top is there. We can see that advancement in the Monsanto hardness, where digital meters are there, and we can check the hardness of the particular tablet. Then we are come with the disintegration apparatus, as we are going to be seeing. It is also very important and is very IP and USP standards. Is already in a practice to check the disintegration time of allopathic or modern medicines, and we are using for our particular medicines. It is give the artificial peristalsis moment, that we are what we are going to be when drug is tablet is taken into stomach, how the peristaltic moment is there and how our tablet is reacting in that. That will be demo here, and we can check the disintegration time of the our tablet. Here we can see there is a, and whatever liquid form is there, that is your normal room temperature and what is there in that particular thing. These are the disc. These discs are representative of your food particles, and below that disc we are keeping the tablet and keep it in a disintegration time. The temperature is fixed for 37 degree. Okay, that is we are going to be, and right now here I want to clear you, any classical drug at Aragvedani 3.50 will not going to for coating, will not allow the government is for coating. That is called uncoated drug. It should be disintegrated in 15 minutes. If it is proprietary medicine with color coating or sugar coating, it is having 30 minutes. And Google Kalpas are there, they are allowed up to 60 minutes. Okay, these are the some criteria they allow. But still, this is not a standard, it's taken into pharmacopoeia, but it is a in process quality control. We have to check it. Then tablet friabilitar, which is the drum is there, where we are going to be check it is there, tablet friability is there. Here we are going to be check the resistance to abrasion, shock, and it is designed. Means when your preg is there, it is transported from one place to another place, it is going to be checked, and it is tumbling is there with the drugs, and it should not be having any breakage, or it is going to not be having friability in that particular structure. Okay, if friability is there, we lose the weight, will not get the desired dose to the particular conditions, by that we are going to be checked. Therefore, friability testing is very important, we have to do it. Then dissolution apparatus, it is used measuring the dissolution rate in a particular medium, okay, acidic, basic medium, how much is the rate, because we are using tablet as a oral dosage form, it should be life cycle and the stability of that particular drug. Because some drugs are going to be changed, their alkalinity and base, they are going to be changed, their properties after environmental conditions. Therefore, dissolution test apparatus is very important for check for your tablet or solid dosage form. Okay, that is we have to check it. Here we are going to be see that this is you are having the chamber, and that is containing particular acid and base media, and the tablet will be cubed, and we have to check the dissolution time, till how much time is required to, and what is the rate of that particular tablet to dissolve it. Then we have come with the melting point apparatus. It is also used for minerals right now, and this is melting point apparatus is a to check the melting of the metals and minerals. For example, right now everybody is knowing that Gandhaka is having melting point is 119 or 120 is the melting point of that sulfur is there. Then how much is going to be changed in the Gandhaka rasayana? Okay, one. Or if it is Gandhaka is there in a pure form after purification, how much is the melting point we can change? How much is going to be changed? We can detect it and we can see it. Or whatever the right now the generally minerals are telling that it is a 99% pure, but it is not like this, because as our Ayurvedic classics, they are given some graha lakshanas to select the drug or identify the drug. That only you should implement. There is no nothing is there. Something is 99 pure, because 99 pure is having 99% side effects also. Then boiling point apparatus, that is also we check by boiling point of your oils, and that to check the adulteration with our tiritela with palm oil or something, because as we check in the specific gravity, here boiling point also help to check. Again, it will going to be checked mrudu madhyam tikshna pak, as we are going to seek in your specific gravity, because specific gravity is having one rate here. Because boiling, because when we are using drug, again we are going for massage or going for particular action for internal purpose or particular for adding with some drug. Therefore, the boiling point is very, because heating of oil, it is too much, because we are using around 1/16 reduction of the kashaya, dudh, and lots of ingredients we are adding, and then we are going to process the oils. Then how much is the change in a saturated and unsaturated fatty acid with that particular drug? Therefore, boiling point is very important, and this is we have to make a standard for that particular drug. Then instrument is coming with the rotary operator, that is efficient and gently remove of your fractions or fractions of the solvent, and we can evaporate. It is under pressure, and it is very not going to be denature the particular your chemicals. Very important, we can concentrate the extract, but here we can't dry the extract. We can concentrate the extract. Okay, that is very important. And here we can recover the whole solvent. Right now, the solvent what we are using for extraction is alcohol, ether. This they are going to be at only room temperature. It is going to be volatile. Here we can going to be recovered. Here we are going to be having some heating chamber, and it is containing water. And under controlled temperature, we can heat it. Where we can't control in water bath or oven or another thing, here we can control, and we can give it under vacuum. It will be faster taken out of your extract solvent, and we can concentrate it. And these are the some instrument I taken, and right now I am entering to some high end analysis. Okay, that is chromatography is one of the everybody is hearing this kind of words, because chromatography is one of the important tool or high end instruments we are using from that particular thing. to analyze or quantify the drug. Right now we are going to be quantify the drug is as a whole, okay, boiling point as a whole, okay, of Kshir Bala tel. We should not go for Bala quantification or Taylor quantification or okay, a particular chemical we are not quantifying. Here we are going to be entering into the pinpoint quantification. Like that, we want to quantify lithanamide. We want to quantify what are the volatile containing the phenyl. We want to see how much is the phenyl containing volatile drugs. What is their mass and what is their particular structure? We are entering in that field, and therefore one first important thing is their chromatography. Here we are using the liquid extraction is there, but they are in a convert into gas and liquid form, and they slowly going to be separate out in a different phases on the liquid or solid stationary phase, and they are showing the components. Okay, chroma means color, graphy means graphical representation. That is simple definition of chromatography is there, and they are generally worked on this principle of adsorption or absorption. That is very important thing. They are working on the adsorption. First very important thing, I think everybody seen this one, column chromatography, or we did it in a paper chromatography. I'm not taken because paper chromatography is not that much used, but we'll go for column chromatography. Here we are going to be isolate the particular phytochemical from the your extract. If you have prepared kashaya or if you are having triflatune, you can isolate the phytochemical from that particular triflatune and take the fraction of the particular extract, and we have to quantify. Or you want to go for eugenol or quantification of particular chemical or alkyl, terminal, chebulin, like that. Then you can isolate by this particular column chromatography, and we can quantify in the higher analysis with the HPTLC or GCMS or particular thing. We can attach with that. This is very simple, and we can go with the automation is possible for this particular thing, but it is generally which is much more manual level, but it is going to be automation is available with this, and we can isolate. Here we can see the extract is the your powder is loaded and the separation is going on and is going to be collected in the dump. Next is very high end analysis we are using, that is HPTLC, that is thin layer chromatography. It is advanced form of thin layer chromatography. It is high performance. Here we can quantify with the standards, or we can see the fingerprinting of the particular drug. Okay, for example, right now TLC and the Ayurvedic Pharmacopoeia of India added TLC as a standard. When you are taken one drug, they given the solvent, where to extract it, what is the mobile phase for that, and how much will be the phytochemical and their RF values are there. Okay, retention factor, that is RF value, it is there. How much is there? It is everything is prescribed in the API, because when detection of phytochemical is there, because drug is right now we are drug is just treating as a whole, but right now drug is containing, as I told previously also, we should not leave a minute phytochemical from any drug. Therefore, we have to go for high end analysis. That TLC, then we have to go for HPTLC. It is for pesticide stability testing, process development is there, in process quality checking. And fingerprinting of application of HPTLC, we can go for particular drug. I just show the examples. This is eugenol in a clove, and you can see there is a first two, that is from one research article I taken, and barely not added his name because this is by mistake. It is there, but it is from one published article I taken. It is here going to be seen that here eugenol is there. Here we can, this is standard eugenol is there, and this is my that sample eugenol is there, A1 and A2. Where we can see that eugenol has particular 0.7, and here also we got in our sample. It is a pure eugenol, and here it is eugenol from lavanga. It is there, and it is actually given into the range of that 6.5 to around 8. Okay, and rest of these are also another phytochemicals are there. It is also important, but particular pinpoint eugenol quantification we are doing here, and for particular thing, this is the HPTLC is going to be help for us. Okay, this is one of the easy and one of the widely used technique, HPTLC into herbal drug standardization. Okay, this is, we are going to be seeing, this is the three samples of your clove is there, and how they differ from their concentrations are there, and which is any they are taken here some samples from market, and there it is absent somewhere. Okay, this is the standards, and we are going to be see, because volatile is passed, your physical chemical test is passed, but if eugenol, like this is very important phytochemical, if it is absent, then your drug action will not be there. Next important thing is your HPLC, high performance liquid chromatography. Here liquid as a source to pass through the particular thing. Here we are going to be the oven, it is there, and oven it is there, then column it is there, we are going to be seen. This is your sample, this is your mobile phase we are keeping here, and we are injecting sample. The injection point is there. Okay, this is the column where separation is happened. Okay, and this is the, you are going to be check the recording system. Right now you are going to be seen here. This is a column, this is your injecting point here, and this is your solvent we are keeping here, and there's a, they are taken out, and this is going to be separated, and we are going to be here. HPLC will help because when we have to clean a liquid form, but limitation is there. We should not inject water soluble extract or water extract, we can't inject here. Only alcohol and other solvent we can use it. Okay, therefore, but we can go for this, we can go for total solids of asphaltene injected, and we can get the one variety of phytochemicals separated out, and we can quantify them, and we can make one graph for HPLC for standard as our order. Okay, well, how it is going to be here, it is there, it is for amino acids are there, how it is there, 18 amino acids they are separated out, and this is a retention time. Here it is a retention time, RT is there, it is calculated, how much time is there retained in this particular column, that is retention time, they are giving pip, and they will quantify, and we can analyze them as they are having library for particular chemicals. What is the chemical is, because we can take it this time, and we can go with the GCMS or mass spectroscopy, where we can getting the mass of particular chemical, and we can identify the particular phytochemical. That is very important thing from this. Then it is, we are having then it is a pesticides. Okay, this is also used for pesticides, and the API is also given this. You have to use it HPLC only for pesticidal analysis and heavy metal. That is for aflatoxins. Okay, there is a two analysis we done by this particular HPLC. That is, we are having carbonyl, diarine. Then these are the pesticides are there, which is used in a particular herbal drugs, or we can spray it or use it in a pesticidal condition. But we have to check there because they are in a parts per million, okay, ppm level. Therefore, this HPLC analysis is required. It can be you. It can be calculated in gravimetric method. That is your precipitation, titrometric method, or you are having limit test. These are three another options are there. But still, for accuracy, we will not get that accuracy in particular thing. Therefore, we have to go with the HPLC analysis. This is for high performance liquid chromatography. This is our aflatoxins, and there is a limit, and there is a for export of any ionic medicines, we have to do this particular test. Then gas chromatography, and this is for generally this gas chromatography is, it is gaseous form, means when you are injecting the extract. Here also you can't inject water extract, you have to inject another extract, so alcohol, ethanol, ether, something, but the phytochemical should be in a gas form. When it is injected, when it is coming to the gas is the carrier over there, it is going to be come react with that, and that will give the analysis. It is generally for volatile components where 300 degree maximum, 300 degree that they are going to be calculated for heating time, and that will be the phytochemical should be viewed from that particular thing and give the detection. These are the gas chromatography. It is from Triflat the Tellum, I taken it is from also one research article, it is published in the article, it is I taken, and you can see there is a one Triflat the Tellum that is going to be oil and some volatile oil containing or below 300 whatever they are giving the their peaks and their concentration of that particular phytochemical. Okay, particular phytochemical, their concentration is there, how much is there, that is very important for this. Then flash chromatography, it is not that much used, but I taken as a additional tool. I'm not added another tools because it is very important, because right now the testing is going to be increasing day by day, because adulteration and substitution is going to be day by day, and the challenges of the drug interaction is also there. It is one of the inexpensive. It is the ideal separation of compound in a gram, up to the gram we can separate it here, and it is a column chromatography, common liquid chromatography, and it is, it is the ideal way to the TLC. It is small kind of TLC, we can do it by this. Yeah, this is the normal phase and reverse phase. Normal phase means whatever right now we see in the HPTL set, they are normals. Sometimes it is going to be reversed to isolate the compound is required. Another spectra we are going to be used, because we are going to be entering into spectroscopy. That is very important from particular drug. It is going to be spectroscopy is another tool where we are going to be use the absorption and emission of the light, okay, and radiation and radiation by the matter and related to dependence of the process of wavelength of the radiation. Right now I have given one picture that light, sunlight, we are going to be concentrated by the lens and the, your paper is going to be burned. Means like that, where we are putting the different light source, and the light source will become and pass through our extracts, and they are giving some structure and detail configuration of your electrons. Okay, right now in HPLC and all we are getting, because there is some backstage data is required to identify the drug. Here, from here onwards in spectroscopy, we can identify the particular structure. That is the advantage in the spectroscopy than chromatography. First, we are, everybody is knowing, and it is vastly using it right now in ayurvedic industry, ayurvedic analysis, that is UV spectroscopy, that is having ultraviolet visible spectroscopy, and this is 200 and 400 nanometer absorbance is there. Here molecules which results in the excited and electrons from the ground to higher state. When you are putting one energy, your particular molecules get energy and they are excited and emit the light, and that is going to be calculated by these instruments. That is UV visible spectroscopy. This is the spectra. Here we can go for quantification of particular phytochemical at particular nanometer. Okay, this particular nanometer we can quantify, and we can say that is concentration of that particular phytochemical at particular nanometer is this much. Okay, right now the ferrous particle, it is also from a research article I have taken. This ferrous particle in water dispersed, and they are going to be, how much this concentration is there, that will be seen. Next is very important, that is we are right now in atomic absorption spectroscopy. This is used for heavy metals mainly, and here atomic absorption is from 190 to 900 nanometer. Okay. Okay, that is very important thing is there, and used for detection of heavy metal and quantification of heavy metals. Here the atoms are in a gaseous stress free. This is Suvarnabhasma spectra I have taken. Okay, it is also from research article I have taken, and how the gold is given, that Suvarna, that is gold spectra is there as a Nobel drug, and how we'll get the AS graph particular for gold. It is there because as we are going to be burned, can make it in ash and oxide form, but still how there it is going to be the spectra, and this spectra can be matched with your original whatever gold we taken from the basma, that you can see the how much changes is there. Then IR and near IR infrared, it is 700 to 250 nanometer. Okay, as how much accuracy has we seen, that sensitivity is required in that level we are going to be seen. Therefore, you can check the wavelength, they are increasing and they are going to be seen. They are interact with the samples and detect to measure the transmitters and absorbance of the light by the IR. Here, potassium bromide is required to prepare the sample. The sample is prepared with the potassium bromide. The extract is react with this. Here in UV and IR, the solution should be clear. Okay, it should not be used colored solution in that case. Here, potassium bromide is required for preparation of medicine, extra sample, and that sample will be introduced in this particular instrument. This is the spectra we are getting. This is silver nanoparticle synthesized by the Artica Diapa. Okay, and this is your absorbance, what we are seeing, the silver nanoparticles are there, and their wavelength, it is there in the infrared, or that detected. Then NMR, it is also one of the instrumentation used, but it is very less used in the particular ayurvedic research, because it is going to be nuclear and strong constant magnetic field and weak oscillating magnetic field, and respond by the producing electromagnetic signals. Here electromagnetic signals are there to prepare, where IR, UV and there the light is concentrated by the monochromators, that is filters, and then it is going to be used. And it is the purity of the sample it is going to be used at, and also used for evaluation of structure of your drug. This is the, and another next is there, your XRD is there. Right now it is used in mineral, and we are going to be see the NaCl powder. It is the XRD where we are going to be see the technique used for phase identification of crystalline material. This is going to be phase identification of crystalline material and providing information on unit cell dimensions. Okay, what is the unit cell dimensions of that particular chemical that is there, and characterization of crystalline material. As right now, as I told, it is going to be used in your bus mass, because the bus mass is going to be extracted when we are giving bhavana and all, that is going to be used. This is the your basma, another there, and there we are going to be the zinc, that is Eschers basma is there. Okay, there is some minute particles are there here. We can see it here. We can see that if they are having some detection of this, this is zinc. Then scanning electron microscope, that is used for standardized qualitative and X-ray. This is SEM, which is normally known, and here we can go for particle size detection of that particular basmite is there. This is the, we are going to use, that is Min Chung et al. They are going to be seeing the nanoparticle synthesized at copper, how they are there, and this was, this is how we, the copper nanoparticle is there, and how their energy is going to be absorbed by that, and how they are giving peak and their concentration is there. Another thing is there, flame photometer. Whatever we seen up to this, they are having some graphical representation. Here again, we are going to use some another instrument, that is they are having concentration. We can say this much is percentage of particular here, flame photometer, and they are giving the mainly analysis of your sodium, potassium, lithium, and calcium. This is going to be seen, and here also we can make it. And here we have to make a concentration of your known sample, calcium, sodium, and that, and then only we can compare with the concentration level of that our sample and particular extract. Or different scanning colorimeter. This analysis technique to heat flow into the out of sample while samples are exposed to controlled temperature. Here we are seeing that it is, we can go for a Pummer-Bohr test. It is going to be where we can get it. If it is free metal is there, we are getting peak of that particular metal is there. I just show, this is we are getting that particular carbonous metal in Nagavasma, and here if it is there any free metal is there, then we can go for say that there is some free metal, but it is in a permissible quantity, no problem. Then colorimeter, here the colored liquid is required, and it is generally used, everybody seen, I think it is in a pathology lab, and so it is used. It is transmit and absorbance of the light, and it is colored solution is required, and it is having, we are getting some, there is some different filters over there to filter the material, filter the light and absorb the light. Here we are getting mg per liter and ppm quantification. Then polarimeter, here we are getting the dextro and levo, okay, optical rotation of the your syrup sample or your sugar containing sample, but sample should be clear, it is very mandatory, it is there, and then only we can say quantify this particular sugar is there, how much is there by polarimeter we can check. Autoclave, we are entering to right now microbiology, some more 2 or 3. Okay, that is autoclave, everybody is knowing this instrument. Here we are going to sterilize the your media and samples. Then laminar airflow, where we are going to be load your samples, so they are containing HIPAA filters, that is very important. They are designed to create a particle free working, should not be altered or giving this any microbial growth come into the drug, because when drug is coming to the practice, should not be affected by our mistakes. It is not going to be failed for that this thing. Then BOD incubator, biological oxygen demand incubator. This is very high end incubator. It is generally used for tissue culture technique also. Right now it is media growth or fermentation, and it is going to be used here. The 5 to 60 degrees with cooling and heating functioning is there. Then TEMS, that is, we see the SEMS here. TEM is also one of the new technique. It is coming. It is smallest thing. We are going to be making image of that particular structure which is unknown to us, and we can go for knowing that particular thing. That is transmission electron microscopy is also coming right now into practice. Then incubator, it is from coming from microbiology to incubate the particular growth. That is a simple incubator we are using. OK, Okay, this is I given almost some part of your instrumentation. What is the actual thing is I want to, I think, given some outward overview of your instrument and their particular applications. Each instrument is having their different types, different companies manufacturing, modifying their functioning to understand softwareing, everything is there to understand. But my particular suggestion to all, customize the present equipment in the right now in the various departments, physics, chemistry, biology, as I told. How can we can customize and we can use it for our standards and bring new standards and create a new standards for Ayurvedic medicines. And we can show that our products are the best products in the world and they are having very safe and very good effect in that particular thing. And development of new instrument as per our need of our standards. Okay. Future area, we can assess the biotechnological instruments. We have to add it. We go for, we are going for DNA RNA separation. And we can say that identification is much precisely than microscopy. We can go beyond this for microscopy. We can go for biotechnological assessment. These are I taken a reference from particular thing. And I am concluding with this remark. I am requesting by my lecturer, please promote plant cultivation. This is your need right now. And this is the future need of Ayurveda. Because these are the best is required for physician to treat the medicines, treat the patients. That is one thing. And thank you very much. And giving thanks to all your team for my patience hearing and giving me opportunity to give talk. Any questions are there? Are invited. Thank you very much, sir.
Informative session. We have a questions here. Shall I ask to continue, sir?
Please continue.
Okay. First question from Dr. Padma. For gas chromatography, how we need to perform? What are the steps? May I know, sir?
Gas chromatography?
Yes, sir. For gas chromatography, how we need to perform?
Gas chromatography, as I told, you have to take extract other than the water. You can go for chloroform or water, chloroform, ether, or whatever it is. Because why I'm telling these two particular extracts? Because chloroform and ether, they are generally very fast evaporated at room temperature. Means once you are injected into the gas chromatography, you inject it. Therefore, this extract we have to prepare and the volatile matter of that particular drug, which is freely soluble in this particular ethanol. Once you will inject it and it is going to be, I'll just show that instrument. Okay, here it is there, and when we are injecting in the injector these samples, and this is what we are getting, auto sampler is there, it is sampling is there, and this is the carrier gas, that is generally nitrogen gas is used here, and that will, when we inject in this particular injector, then the gas will be the carrier, and this is the recorder where we can record in the mass. Okay, that is the instrument is working on.
Thank you, sir. Next question. Sir, whether we can perform?
Yes.
Wait a minute, sir. Next question, sir. Whether we can perform gas chromatography for herbal smoke, sir? If yes, means what are the steps?
Smoke, we can go for AS is better. Okay. Atomic absorption spectroscopy or we can go gas chromatography, we can't go for smoke because we have to inject in the liquid form here. Then it is going to be heat and then it is going to be carried. The smoke, we can't go for this. We go for AS where we can analyze or see the atomic absorption spectroscopy, better instrument for smoke.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Next question from Dr. Madhuri. Sir, how to check the genuinity of honey and cow ghee?
Honey, it is better. A simple technique is first is your artificial sugar. Okay. Chlorophenol is the main chemical where we can going to be treat with the honey. Then it is a pinkish color is there. Chlorophenol, when we are preparing, it is a alcoholic extract or water solution is there. And if you put into the honey, if it is giving pink color, Okay, I'm repeating. It is giving pink color means it is containing artificial flavor. If it is genuine honey, it should not contain any artificial flavor. Okay, one. Honey, it is honey, and ghee, it is basic thing I given. And for cow ghee, we are giving the standard by the API, the melting point range, when we are particular acid value, saponification value, then your iodine saponification, and another one is there. I just mean these two three tests are there. That is API is given already ranges for that particular cow ghee. That should be specified. Otherwise, if it is added by Dalda and anything, we go for any microchemical test that is going to be altered. I think Sudan 3 it is there. Chemical is there where we can test it. Where color is changing. Or it is Dalda is there or something.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Next question from Dr. Suma Krishnaswamy. What are the important analysis methods followed for stability studies for polyherbal formulations?
Okay, polyherbal is there. One is there in stability study. When we are going to be, parameters are decided by as per the form. Okay, one. Second, what we are going from, right from description. Okay, right from macro, micro, then physicochemical, then chemical evaluation. In chemical evaluation, pre-mephitic chemical evaluation and quantification of the chemical by any method. You can go with that HPTLC, or you can quantify the particular group, like alkaloid analysis, total alkaloid content, UV, or sorry, total tannin contents. Like, you have to quantify the particular group which is present in that particular polyhydrate formulation. Okay, but again, the physical parameter you decide by the form. If it is oil is there, polyhydrate formulation, if it is oil is there, then we are going for oil specification. Churna is there, churna specification, tablet is there, tablet. Okay, it's going to be like.
Thank you, sir. Next question from Seema. Sample injecting techniques in HPLC or HPTLC. Can you tell, sir?
Yes, sample injecting technique in HPLC and HPTLC, they are having injectors are there. Okay, just like syringe are there, which is, I just show it is there, I think, in my slides. Okay, not HPTLC, it is there. Okay. Here, we are getting one left side photograph. Okay, it is here. We are just beyond that is sample technique, is injector is there. Okay, that is totally automated. Okay, in HPLC somewhere it is going to be, you can use it by manual also. There is no issue for this. In HPLC totally by the, that is injector is there, what Linomet it is there, which is Canac company is there, that is HPLC is here. Injecting through the syringe, where we can quantify particular sample to how much we are injecting, because the sample quantity, what we are injecting, that is also before the separation. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Next question from Anurupa, doctor. What are the important tests for analysis of Parada, as many of the instruments are limited for liquid samples?
Parada, we have to go with the HG assay there. You can go for HG assay. And as I told, in sulfur also, you should not go for 99% purity. Whatever the classical, our parameter is given to check the minerals, we have to assess that one. Then we go for up to the assay of your Parada. Okay, you can go with the AS, where we can get some, if it is a 70% or 60%, it's another some impurities with this, which is having with that particular Parada. We can go with the up to AS, where we can check the, what is the attachment with your HT sample, that we can go for this. And physical sample is where we are going to receive that macro, micro, it is there, color, odor, taste, whatever, it's very last classical, go for. And it is also present in your, you can refer for this IP, where HG is there, where we can go for, I think it is in UPI also there.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Here the questions are over. Thank you so much for your valuable session, sir. And I would like to call upon Dr. Vasant Patil, sir, for a vote of thanks.
Hello.
Sir, please.
Good noon, everybody. Dr. Ajit Lingayat, sir, has exponentially and very detailed and systematically covered all the aspects of quality control, especially raw drug standardization, process standardization, quality control, and the finished products. All three areas he has covered very nicely, the applications of different instruments,
in the research lab and as well as the various products. He has illustrated some, he has given example regarding the Google Kalpana and Gruta Kalpana, etc., etc. So it is the need of the hour for the Ayurvedic students to know the basic idea of the applications of instrument. At least even the practitioner also, he can able to, whenever there is a doubt regarding the standard or the quality, poor quality is there, quality issue is there, then he can have a basic idea to get it done in the lab, and he can complain to the drug controlling authority. That is the issue nowadays. You are in this competition era, there is a 80%, nearly 60 to 70% adulteration is there. You are not getting genuine quality shilajatu, Google, etc. Google, if you see some Google company, they won't digest, even disintegrate the 60 or 70 year old patients. They will get the tablet as means the in the stool, the whole tablet he will pass without disintegration. That is the bad quality. Such bad quality products are there in market. So in order to avoid all these things, even government is not strictly imposing the regulations. If they impose, 80% pharma companies will close. That is the scenario. That's why we have to use the modern techniques and tools for standardizing and making the quality assurance. I know 90% of the India institutes in India, they don't have these setups. All the MD scholars, they are assigning to the outsourcing to the bigger labs like Amul, etc., in Hyderabad, Mumbai, and some nearby centers. They are in only metros. That is the problem. And in academic studies, they are not following all these standard QC techniques or quality assurance techniques, all these things. That is one thing. In Mysore, CFTRI is there. That is doing all these, they are doing all these tests. So anyone who is interested, the RSBK or other scholars also, even other Basti, we can see whether it is properly done or not. Basti, oil in water emulsion or water in oil emulsion, you can see, check in that also for standardization purpose. All those things, sir has given a very vivid explanation regarding all these QC. And we are very much thankful to Dr. Ajit Lingayat for contributing his valuable time for delivering this very highly quality and informative lecture. I'm very much thankful to him. And so I request Dr. Ajit, if you have time, pharmacognosy, one lecture on pharmacognosy also, please. And all the students who are attending this, you can share the YouTube and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can share maximum this presentation so that they can also get benefited from this. And I'm thanks to Dr. Meena Patil and Dr. Piki and Dr. Kendamurt and all the participants for their valuable interaction and participation. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks, sir.
Thank you, sir. Now meeting can be dismissed.